Now, one of the things that's interesting about a Manson engine. Okay, I've turned the fish tank off. You won't be able to hear the bubbling in the background. We might be able to hear this Manson engine running because one of the interesting things about a Manson engine, unlike a Stirling cycle engine, it's actually has openings to the outside air. Now, a Stirling cycle engine is a closed engine. The gases are enclosed in the engine and don't vent to the outside in any way. But this little Manson engine has an exhaust, and I've seen Manson engines on the internet where they've sort of put a trumpet on that exhaust, and you can get quite a reasonable chuffing sound. This one has a tiny chuffing sound. You can hardly hear it. But you can hear it, and we're going to see if we can hear that now if I silence everything else in the room. Okay, so that's almost invisible, that flame. Yeah, it's pretty hard to see. I'm just going to see if I can get my focusing correct here. Okay. So here we have the Manson cycle engine built by Contax Engineering in the UK in 2016. This has the brass cylinder and the brass piston coated in tungsten for low friction. This engine has three moving parts, just three. I think the only way you could get fewer moving parts is with an electrical. An electric motor has one moving part. And I've seen some other interesting things. For example, an engine with memory metal. This engine works equally well in either direction and has that opening to the outside air through here, rather than being a closed cycle Stirling engine where there's no meant to be no exhaust anywhere. This does have an intake and exhaust all in the stroke, so it's fascinating how they work. In fact, it would do your head in how they work. You can figure it out, obviously, it's been figured out. I struggle with it. I don't have any problem visualizing the Stirling cycle or the steam engine cycle. We have a really small flame here and not much. Not very fast running engine, but you can see, and we're going to see if we can speed that up a bit so we can hear it. So what I've done is I've pulled that little bit of wick out. We're going to light a bigger flame underneath it, and we're going to see if we can get that. Making a fast run. Okay, well, I can just hear it starting to chuff. But like most engines from Contax, it's very nearly silent. So I'm going to put this up to the microphone. Now, if we compare that to something like a an ordinary Stirling engine, which I'm going to run in another one of my videos. For example, solar engines from the USA. Well, there's a whole lot of difference in the kind of mechanical noise that you'll get. Now, this runs beautifully fast, quiet. I wish it would focus. Turn that around a bit. Simple modular construction. Go and have a look at Contax's website and you can see how they can offer a bunch of different models using, I think they're going to use some common parts, not just bases, possibly also cylinders, you know, wheels, connecting rods, burners. So smart people, high quality, good value, I think. Well, particularly when you work the postage, international postage into it. So I'm going to stop this now and I'm going to run it. It's going to run quite happily in either direction. I guess my only complaint, and it's not really a complaint, about these engines is they're pretty tiny. I do call them micro engines, and they do make bigger engines. The bigger engines are considerably more expensive. One thing I would say, though, if you liked the Japanese Ross Yoke engine that I showed you the other day, well, Contax make a version of that with a graphite piston. They also make a Gamma Cycle engine, the rear rhombic drive engine, which I would probably be the next engine I'll get, and they make a beautiful job of that, as with everything else. They have videos on their website. It's a good website, contax.co.uk. Okay, thanks for watching.